and welcome to The Real Deal. Now, NAR's Time Is Illmatic is the story of the environment and the influences that went into the creation of one of hip-hop's seminal albums.
Dissecting the album song by song while telling the story of NAR's, it may be more than just a film for the fans and Joe. Here's a clip.
I had a passion for music. That was going to be my out.
I said to my boss, please let me sign this kid.
I was trying to make the perfect out.
Within a week, everybody wanted to know who that guy was.
I gave you what the streets felt like, sounded like, tasted like. I had to block that hate out or tear that down. And my choice was to tear it down.
Okay, I kind of know exactly what I'm going to get from this review. Yeah, okay, so good?
It's great. I loved it. Obviously, I'm a massive hip-hop fan, but I think it has an interesting device at its heart as well. Basically, Illmatic is a very important album in the history of hip-hop. This isn't a niche thing. Hip-hop is the biggest selling music form on Earth. It's mainstream music. So to see where that came from is an interesting thing. Nas is also a very important artist in hip-hop. What it does cleverly is this album is very well known, okay? Maybe not by you modern kids today, but it is a well-known album. And the device it uses is it uses each song in the album to knit together the story of how not only the album was made, but of what was going on in Nas's life at that time. So it draws direct parallels between the content of the song and, say, for example, him struggling to be a rapper, or his best friend being shot and killed. Things like that.
That basically need an hour-long show because you could talk about this forever.
Yeah, I mean, I think that's an interesting device. I also think if you love the music, then you're going to love this. Hairs on the back of my neck stood up. The lad next to me, I don't know who he was because he had a bucket hat pulled real low over his eyes.
Oh, he's so street.
He was so street in a screening full of critics as well. Yeah, it wasn't exactly downtown Queens. But he rapped along to every lyric, and I wanted to as well.
Could I rap along to every lyric in this film?
Well, you could, interestingly enough, because at some points they actually put them on screen.
Oh my God, it's like sing-along Nas.
It's like a Disney sing-along film, but with much more gun violence.
Okay.
It is really interesting. I think that device is interesting, and I think it's a good tale as well for the uninitiated to learn a bit more about hip-hop culture and where these guys come from as well. But I understand that it might seem like one for the fans.
Okay. Okay, so I kind of brought it up before in jest, but I'm not a hip-hop fan. I'm sorry.
Oh, really? Yeah.
I'm not! So, am I going to go and watch this? Who is going to go and watch this other than hip-hop fans? And does it tell us something that will, other than, you know, the love of Nas, like, does it tell us something different? Is it cinematic enough?
This is the thing. You touched on something interesting there with the cinematic quality. This is a bit of a camp review for a rap film, isn't it? Sorry, Nas. The cinematic element is negligible.
Okay.
It would work well as a TV documentary. What they did to try and make it a bit more cinematic is there's a couple of bits that they just put in slow-mo. To like him getting out of a car. And it's like, that doesn't need...
Maybe we should do our reviews in slow-mo to make it more dramatic.
No,
it's okay.
That was Baywatch.
All right.
That doesn't need to be there. So yeah, it's maybe not cinematic. If you are a fan of the genre, you'll definitely love this. It's probably the best hip-hop documentary, I think, since the Up in Smoke tour documentary. Hey, guys, you know what I'm talking about.
Referencing.
My homies on the street, you guys know what I'm saying. but that being said, if you're not a fan of the genre, maybe not so much.
Okay.
But I do actually think there's an interesting tale here about, generally speaking, hip-hop music, social deprivation in general, and also how these records get made. I mean, there's a bit where a guy's talking about he used to do mixes out the front of his apartment block, out the window, and if someone walked past on this pavement they didn't dance, he would just start again. And I think it's a very interesting subculture for the uninitiated to look at, but yeah, might be kind of niche.
All right, so these good people at home are going to be heading to the cinema and maybe thinking, oh, Nas, niche.
What was that sound?
So in that respect, what's the star rating and what's the real deal on this film?
The real deal on Nars Time Is Illmatic is if you're a fan of the genre, then this is the only film you need to see at the moment. It's honestly, you'll absolutely love it. And good films about music you like, no matter what type of music it is, come along very rarely. So in that sense, definitely worth going to watch. If you're interested in the subculture of hip-hop generally, and of that kind of social deprivation and music coming out of that, then you'll also, there's something there for you too. And what I really hope is that people who don't know about Nars take something away from this and go and listen to him. That being said, I'm realistic enough to know that vast swathes of the audience are going to be turned off from it by its very nature. I'd like to give it 5 stars. Realistically, 3.5.
Okay, so there we go. Obviously, Joe loved it, but he is in the massive minority of niche fans for this film, so it might not be for everyone. Thank you for tuning in to us on TheRealDealOnFilm.com, our wonderful website. And of course, you can let us know your thoughts by tweeting us at The Real Film Show. Thanks for watching.